Hi, I'm Vlad and I work in the consular section. Today is FSN Appreciation Day, and I wanted, on behalf of the consular section, express appreciation to all of our local staff. Not, of course, only to my wonderful staff, but also to all the local staff that work all around this mission to help us do our work. I've been in the Foreign Service for 16 years, and working with our local colleagues around the world has been my most favorite part of working for the State Department. I know your supervisors told you this many times, but I'm going to say this again. We could not do this work without you. We couldn't do it without your help, and we couldn't do it without your support. But what I particularly appreciate about the staff here is, in addition to your great expertise in the jobs that you do and your dedication to your work, you also make us really feel welcome in this place. You make us feel part of Jerusalem, part of this mission, part of the family that has been here for a long time. And this is what I've most enjoyed about living and working here. So thank you again very much for everything you do every day. Shukran.
Masal khair, ya shabab. I'm Jill Hutchings here with a few members of the political team, and we just want to say thank you for your incredible work. We are blessed with five, and we're biased, I think, a little bit, of some of the best local nationals I have ever worked with. Each one of them is carrying out incredible work that we cannot do by ourselves. I can't think of any day in my life here in Jerusalem that I haven't relied on the wisdom of each of those five members or random people I stop and ask them directions, help me navigate. You guys are the keys to our success. So thank you from the bottom of my heart, wherever you are. If you can't see this, just know we really appreciate your work. Team on three, one, two, three, thank you!
Hello, my name is Helena Rosas. I have been working at the U.S. Embassy for the past 3 years in Jerusalem. I work at the IRM section as a telecom account specialist. Let me introduce you to my fellows. Our section is responsible to ensure that all the newcomers have lines and internet in their residences, to make sure the bills are paid on time, and to keep records of for all the official lines and circuits, and much, much more. Our section is not just a section. We are family, and we're here to support the mission. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Stacey Barrios. I'm the Public Affairs Officer for the Palestinian Affairs Unit Public Diplomacy Section. Our local staff colleagues in the PD section are the faces and voices of the United States to the Palestinian people. And they help us and our colleagues both in DC and across the mission to truly hear, see, and understand the faces and voices of the Palestinians with whom we engage. Their efforts to keep the door open to American-Palestinian engagement and exchange benefit both peoples and keep America's mission here moving forward. They do so with dedication, expertise, and diplomacy that is truly extraordinary, and usually they do so in very complicated circumstances. We owe them our success in achieving our mission, and we could not be more grateful to them. Thank you, POW PD team.
مرحبا، اسمي هبال أيام من الكونسلر سكشن بأرنونا. بشتغل بالنان إيميجرنت فيزا سكشن. شغلي لإلي بيعني كتير، بس أكتر إشي بيعني لإلي إني أساعد الناس. لما نعطي الناس فيزا يروحوا يزوروا أهلهم، نعطي لناس فيزا يروحوا يتعلموا بأمريكا، يغيروا حياتهم كلها، يغيروا مستقبلهم. لما نعطي ناس فيزا يروحوا يتعالجوا بأمريكا، بيعني لإلي إنه أساعد الناس وإنه نغير حياتهم كلها. فكتير فخورة فينا وكتير فخورة بشغلنا.
We are so fortunate in the Palestinian Affairs Unit Economic Section to have such a knowledgeable and dedicated team of local staff, and they're nice too. Each of them brings special strengths to our section's work. Amr is literally our eyes, ears, and voice in Gaza. It would be impossible to do our work without him and without the PD and management staff that support his work and travel. He, along with our LES in Gaza, is constantly subjected to harassment and threats to his safety. Yet even when a missile lands 100 meters from his home, Amr sends in reports. Amr plays an indispensable role in informing U.S. foreign policy every day. Elias, our numbers guy, is always generous, both with his time and his knowledge. One of the best analytical minds in the mission and a constant learner, he consistently provides accurate analyses and forecasts of the Palestinian economy, often days or even weeks ahead of professionals at the World Bank, IMF, and other missions. He remains a vital voice, informing the State Department, the Treasury, and the White House on macroeconomic and fiscal issues in the region. Jarir knows everybody. He has a wealth of contacts throughout the Palestinian private sector and even in the Israeli government. Jarir's relationships have proven indispensable in pursuit of our goals, especially to reducing movement and access barriers for Palestinians. Jarir's sterling reputation and years of experience working on economic growth in the West Bank have repeatedly opened doors for us that were not readily available before. We are really lucky to have Jarir, Elias, and Amr on our team. Thank you for what you do every day.
Hello, my name is Uri Mordechai, and I work in the U.S. Consulate, now the U.S. Embassy, since 1991. I started as a regular guard and became the local guard force commander 20 years ago. I want to tell you today that I'm very proud to be part of this place. This place to me is like a second home. To see so many people from so many different backgrounds and religions all working together is a great thing to me. I also believe that this place should be an example for the people from the outside to come and see how we all work together as one team. As part of my role as the chair of the LES committee, we also constantly meet with management to improve the morale of people, to overcome issues of employee staff, and to bridge the gaps between employees and management.
Hello, I'm Lance Bryan, management officer. And on behalf of the entire management section, I want to thank our local staff for all the work that you have done for us over the years. I constantly draw inspiration from each and every one of you. You've been with us through thick and thin, and I want you to know how much we sincerely appreciate it. Americans come and go, but you are the backbone of this operation. And I also have some other members of the management team here who would also like to express their appreciation.
Hello, I'm James May, the IMO here at Embassy Jerusalem, and I'm proud of the many achievements of my IRM section. With IC, they continue to improve and expand our IT infrastructure all behind the scenes while supporting our customers' daily events, our requests. The telecom team manages our IT contracts and just recently found tens of thousands of dollars in savings. The mailroom consistently meets the growing demands of mail delivery of all our customers. And finally, I also want to highlight the FMO section and just the partnership they have given both the IRM section and the rest of the management section in funding all of our requests. And I'll hand it over to GSO now.
Hi, I'm Philip Wilson, the SGSO here at Embassy Jerusalem. I'd like to talk about the GSO and facility sections. They're absolutely amazing. I'll briefly touch on each portfolio. First, the housing. They've done an amazing job to add 10 new units to the housing pool while juggling 6 major leases at various stages. The motor pool, last year they saw the biggest turnover in vehicles in several years, both GOVs and POVs, and they keep us rolling along. Travel, they've demonstrated superb flexibility when charting the course to a new combined travel and visits unit. Also warehouse, the superb team, they have completed the annual inventory in record time. They also completed the residential inventory, another sign of their commitment to excellent service. Procurement, they've done an amazing job to help clear out over 3,000 electronic procurement files that help prepare us for the future. Customs and shipping, they're working very closely with Tel Aviv to streamline and enhance our shipping processes as part of the merger with the Tel Aviv Customs and Shipping Office. It's going to be a great merger. And of course, facilities. The entire team has done an amazing job to keep so many diverse properties all across Jerusalem up and running while managing many OBO projects at the same time. We could not work in these offices without them. I'd like to turn it over to our next.
Hi, my name is John Vu. I am the EPAP Associate for Human Resources. I'm just also proud of our HR section. They are the backbone of the backbone, because what would you do without staffing? For our LA staff team has done a fantastic job in recruiting and retaining staff and keeping everyone happy, as well as our American team on welcoming our American EFMs and ensuring that the transition is very smooth. And I also want to do a special shout out to our medical section, who keeps our community healthy and happy.
My name is Ayub Tatunji. I work for the PD. I manage the undergraduate exchange program. I've been working for the mission for the past 6 years. Coming to work every day is a pleasure. Working on engaging Palestinian youth with the American culture and having such a great atmosphere in the mission.
Hi, I'm Kirby Rosenbluth, Regional Security Officer at the U.S. Embassy Jerusalem. In March 2001, I arrived as a young ARSO to serve in Jerusalem. And the lessons I learned as a result of that first tour, as a result of the mentoring, friendship and training I received through my local staff has now served me for 20 years as a member of the Foreign Service. I'm now fortunate to have been able to return to Jerusalem as the RSO and still work with so many of these fantastic local employees. The friendship, the professionalism, and the camaraderie that I get to experience every day by working with my local staff and the entire embassy community is something that I treasure and makes my foreign service experience that much more satisfying to me. Thank you for all you do and for your friendship.
How you doing? I'm Colonel Sean Crockett. I'm the Chief of Staff for the United States Security Coordinator. I just want to personally express my appreciation for our four local employees. We have four Palestinians that serve with the USSC currently. Rami is the coordinator's driver, and he spends a lot of time on the road with the boss, knows every last back road between here and the West Bank. Phenomenal individual, does a lot of great work, and again, he's on the road with the boss 24/7. Rowan, my partner in crime, she runs the administrative section. She is the backbone of the USSC. Any administrative need, whether in processing new folks like myself, when it comes to vouchers, travel schedules, all of those things, Rowan is my right-hand man and helps myself and the aide de camp every day. Joe Gork is the boss's translator. He also travels with the boss pretty much every time the boss interacts with senior leaders of the Palestinian Authority security forces. Tremendous. We call him Dr. Joe. He does have a PhD. Tremendous individual and his ability to help the boss translate some very, very complex subject areas. And then finally, Tamara. Tamara is the coordinator's regional political advisor. Again, a Palestinian, she knows most of the senior leaders in the Palestinian Authority, as well as interactions and setting up meetings for both Palestinian Authority leaders, as well as key leaders like in Jordan. And so she is absolutely critical to the coordinator's role and the mission high-level key leader engagements that he conducts on any given day. And oh, by the way, Tamara is also the NEA 2019 NEA Bureau FSN of the Year. And she is actually today, I believe receiving or yesterday, received from Secretary of State Pompeo in DC that award. So tremendous recognition, and I'll be talking about her a little bit later today face to face. Thank you all very much.